no.
Oh no.
Oh no.
You lost me.
No, I lost Pando. You're there. I lost Pando.
Oh, I'm here.
What happened to Pando?
I took Pando out.
Oh no.
It's me now.
All right, I guess I'll just hide that for now. It was literally just there. I'll move you over here too. All right, hello everyone, and welcome to the Nerd Bites Weekly Show. I am your host, DC, and today I am accompanied by a salamander. Sal is joining me. What's up, Sal?
What is up, everybody?
You'll see his little icon in the top left-hand or right-hand corner, along with me. And we have a jam-packed show for you tonight. Mostly we're talking about the PlayStation Showcase because there's a lot to talk about there. But there's other stuff we were going to discuss too. So yeah, man, how you doing?
Doing pretty good. Before this, I was playing Kingdom Come Deliverance. I don't know if you ever played that one.
Never played it.
It's like a medieval type game, but it's a little bit more realistic. So like, I don't know, you can die from like, I don't know, like getting stabbed. Like most people, but like someone scratches you and you're like, I'm bleeding to death now.
Oh, so it's like realistic. It's like,
yeah,
you get hit by a brick in the side of the head, you're gonna die of
pretty much
brain trauma.
And like, yeah, at the beginning, like I suck, so like I try to do a bunch of like checks or whatever, like, you know, like charisma checks, and they're like, fuck you, dude, you suck, go to the brig.
All right. Well, we'll you're a streamer, and I watch your stream when I get a chance. With the kiddos, it's harder to do that because, you know, they always take over.
Understandable.
But I watch you when I can, and you were playing this really interesting game a couple days ago.
Which one?
The like Outlast replacement type deal?
Oh, Outlast Trials? Yeah. That's like the co-op Outlast. I guess I've been told it's like Dead by Daylight. I haven't played Dead by Daylight, but
I haven't either. I've heard a lot of good things about that game, though.
From what I see, it's pretty much the same thing, just like first person. But I was playing with my girlfriend Reap, and it was a blast. Actually, I actually want to go back and play. We just haven't had a time.
I might have to check it out. Something we should team up on is the Starship Troopers game. Looks like a lot of fun. And like a bunch of buzz around it right now. So we should co-stream that.
100%. I'm down for that. I love killing bugs. Those movies are awesome too. You ever watch them?
Oh, dude. Yeah. The first one, especially. Love it. Love it. We got Karen in the house. We got Ketsorin, who's still taking some time off. She's here though, hanging out in chat. We got Reaper in the chat. So thanks for joining us, everybody. So something I wanted to touch on before we talk about PlayStation is last week it kind of flew under the radar a little bit, but there was a big announcement from Blizzard about Overwatch 2, and the PvE is dead.
It actually feels like it never even began. Like, it was just kind of like, yeah, you guys remember what you're waiting for that?
Yep.
Nah.
Yeah, very disappointing. You know, I guess it's one of those things where, you know, you don't, it's a free to play game, so you didn't pay for it anyway. But I guess if people invested in like the season passes and stuff, expecting to get content, you know, for the skins to be able to use during PvE or whatever, I don't know. Maybe they can complain about that, but it's just very disappointing because it looked great. The concept of it was amazing. And, you know, I love PvE. I think there should be more PvE games.
Absolutely.
And, you know, don't get me wrong, I love Overwatch. Hell, I played it last night for like 3 hours. But it's just having that extra element. I know there's a lot of people out there that aren't huge fans of, good God, Ketsorin, there aren't huge fans of PvP, you know. PvE is such a good option. But I don't know. What's your take on that? You talk about it while I put this stupid headband on.
Sure. So, I mean, for me, I still love Overwatch as well, but, you know, we were promised more stuff, and we're not getting more stuff. We're getting more of the same, and actually less of the same. Like, it just feels like it's not Overwatch 1. And I was looking forward to seeing these characters, like, be, like, blown up story-wise. You know, like, we get, like, the videos, and those are cool and everything, but I would like to actually play through a little bit more tighter story. Like, you know, all these characters intertwining with each other, because, like, now when you go in there, like, Mortal Kombat, I've been playing the shit out of that. They have a cool thing where, like, every time you start a battle with two characters, like Scorpion or Sub-Zero, they have, like, a personal quip that begins. I would love to see something like that, like, because of the PvE, you know, because you're playing more of a story going. But anyway,
dude, no, 100%. Like, if nothing else, that the story, that, because like you mentioned, like, they have those excerpts that they have, those little short vids of characters' backstories, which we've only got so many. We haven't gotten one for every character. Having that, like, little backstories you could play through for each character, that sounds phenomenal. Like, give me lore. I love lore.
Yeah, and you hear these characters like, oh, this is so-and-so's, like, teacher. And it's like, well, when the fuck was that established? Oh, you got to go looking for that. It's like, okay, well, can I, like, play that? Like, can I, like, get a cool cinematic, like, in-game? Or, but anyway, they just said fuck all that and keep playing your stupid stuff, so. Which I probably will anyway, but it's just disappointing.
Yeah, no, I'm still going to play it, but it is definitely frustrating. Yeah, man, I don't know. And then the Gollum game dropped, which is getting awful reviews. I think it was at like a 40% on Metacritic.
Yeah, I was on TikTok and I was watching like all the bugs. Like, it's just, I'm already like not interested because it's Gollum of all fucking people. Like, I can't imagine what that game could possibly be to reel me in. Like, you're in the caves, like, slowly losing your hair and eating fish. It's like, all right, well, I don't care.
Sounds great. It'll lose its appeal after like 10 minutes.
Yeah. Well, it seems like even the people who like wanted to try it out were punished with shitty game. So that's a great start.
You know, I'm a huge LOTOR fan, and I was not a fan of Rings of Power at all. I think that was an awful show. It looked really pretty, and that was about the extent of it. Feels like Lord of the Rings fans have been slapped in the face a lot recently.
Yeah, I totally missed the hype for that. Like, by the time I was like, I think I should watch the show, they're like, don't. It's bad.
Dude, no. Yeah, I gave up after like 4 episodes or something. I was like, I cannot put myself through this anymore. And I know it gets worse, apparently, so I'm good on that.
Which sucks, man. There's such like a huge like world that like, I don't know what they, so with this story, are they like going off of like Tolkien shit, or is just they made their own thing and it just went awful?
Yeah, it's like loosely based on some of the stuff from the Silmarillion, but it's not a good adaptation at all. This is not what he had intended with that story, with those little mini stories that he had in that book.
He didn't die for this.
Yes, Rings of Power, Ketsorin, it's bad. Yeah. And Karen says LOTOR indexes, they don't have the rights to this Silmarillion. Yeah, you're right. But I think it was like around that time, though, not from the book itself. That's why I said loosely based off of. Yeah. But yeah, it's bad. Don't even bother watching it. But yeah, I don't know. It's annoying because, like I said, those are my favorite books ever, and it's just frustrating.
I get that. Yeah, I'm off the show hype. Lately, it's just been all anime for me lately.
Hey, but what you been watching?
Hell's Paradise. Been going back and finally trying to finish Made in Abyss, if you ever check that one out.
Love it so much.
And then Demon Slayer, of course.
Mm-hmm.
Been really good. Absolutely. I'm always at the edge. I'm always thinking like, I'm going to like, ugh, who cares? And then I watch it. I'm like damn near in tears. Like, this is beautiful. I love this.
Yep.
Especially that last episode. It was fucking good. But yeah, that's pretty much it as far as stuff I've been watching currently.
Oshi no Ko. You need to watch it, bro. I'm telling you. Yeah,
it's on the list.
It's going to be the anime of Rebels. The year.
And I don't know if that falls under animes, but I've been watching Rebels.
Oh, Star Wars Rebels?
Yeah.
Well, that's for the first time. So. But where are you at there? Like, how far into it are you?
I guess for people who want to watch it, lurk now, forever hold your peace. That's usually what I say. But I'm at the part where like they did the time skip, so Ezra's like a big boy and cut his hair. And I'm at the actual episode where what's General Soto? Is that his name? Like, his nephew is like on a planet just like yeah. throwing shit at people. That's yep. that's where I left off at.
Dude, oh my God, you're getting into the meat and potatoes of that show, and it yeah. is too good. It is too good. But yeah, going back to anime real quick, Hell's Paradise has been really good. Really pretty mm-hmm. animation. Surprising last episode, by the way.
Today's? I didn't watch today's.
No, not today's. Like last week's.
Gotcha. Yeah, 100%.
Yeah, very
surprised. I feel like they're packed. Like, though, I think the one before that was like really packed with like stuff. Because like, I like animes like this, and that's why I like Made in Abyss. They like sprinkle in a mystery.
Yep.
And then when you get there, you're like hit with so much like, oh, this is not what you expect at all. Like, this place sucks. Like,
yeah.
And you're out of your depth every possible way. You might have been anime in your world, but like not here, dude.
Made in Abyss is the best depressing fantasy anime of all time.
Yeah, I've gotten to the part where like they met with the really strong lady, the one like that's sitting in the halfway point, I guess.
Yeah, so you're not like at the golden whatever it's called arc yet, right? Season Mm-mm. 2.
Mm-mm.
Dude, oh my God, it is heart-wrenching, gut-wrenching, whatever you want to say, but both. It is, but it's also just beautiful, and it's just such a good story. Like that is the way fantasy should be. That mm-hmm. anime is the way fantasy should be. The sense of wonder and adventure and like realization, like you said, that oh shit, this actually sucks.
Yeah.
Well, you're stuck now, motherfuckers.
Yep. You wanted this, literally, so.
Yeah. All right, going back to the chat real quick. Karen and Ketsorin are having a heyday about Rings of Power. So
you lit the flame.
Ketsorin said it's not bad. It's an off thing. Take out what Amazon had to work with and the bad adaptation of Princess Elf Lady. She said, but I think the biggest thing is that it didn't hit because of the intellectual rights that Amazon couldn't get. And
well, why even bother then? Like, right. I mean, if you can't tell the whole story, like it's still bad.
Yeah.
You know, and if you can't do it, I guess make your own story. Stop trying to like include bigger characters.
Right.
Like, I don't know. You ever play Shadow of War? Like, I love that like game a lot. Like Talion like doesn't exist anywhere, but like, I love that story so much.
Yep.
So,
Karen says Ketsorin is preaching and therefore it should not have been touched at this time. 100%.
Mm-hmm.
And said, P.S. Duren's wife 100% should have had a beard. Homegirl was beautiful. but yeah. God, they're just having a love affair in the chat right now. Ketsorin and Karen are. but yeah, it doesn't like you said, Sal, like don't even make it to begin with. If you can't get the rights to like, you know, you can't think outside the box and adapt it, you know, a proper way, then don't even bother.
I agree. That's like kind of like the Master Chief stuff. I mean, it's still bad, even though it's there. Like it's, or like the Halo show.
I'll never watch it. I won't even bother. I love it's Halo like, so much.
Well, I mean, to be fair, Halo's games, like, I've lost the storytelling touch too, but. It is what it is.
It is what it is. Hey, speaking of Destiny, or not Destiny, Bungie. Jesus. Speaking of Bungie, even though Bungie doesn't run Halo anymore, let's talk about the PlayStation Showcase. Like I said, tons to unpack. And really probably the best way I think we can do it is I'll have the IGN article on screen about everything announced, mm-hmm. and we'll just kind of run through it all and give our thoughts. Sound good?
That sounds good.
And chat, let us know your thoughts too. We'll take pauses to talk about that. Okay. So, yeah, the heavy hitter right off the bat, of course. I'm surprised they didn't end with this since they ended with it at the show, but Spider-Man 2. Oh my God. Like,
yeah.
That game looks like it's going to have literally everything a Spider-Man fan could want.
Did you play the other two?
Dude, of course.
See, what I like about these stories is like it's like kind of like the Gotham games where like you have a lot of big hitter like villains and they're all like really well done.
Yep.
Because like we got Venom, symbiote suit Spider-Man, so Venom's there, obviously.
Yep.
Kraven the Hunter, which I'll be real, I missed the that was him, but I know that's a big plot point on that one.
Right here.
So.
Yeah. So, dude, yeah, of course, I'm like the biggest Spider-Man fan on the planet. I sold my original PS4 so I could get the PS4 Pro with the Spider-Man edition. It's in my basement right now, just like sitting there looking pretty.
Nice.
Yeah. Karen also is a huge Spider-Man fan. Karen, shouts out. But yeah, no, Kraven the Hunter is one of the best Spider-Man villains, to be honest. Hunted him several times throughout the comics and in the 90s show. It's a really good choice for a main big bad. Well, I guess like a sub big bad, because really Venom is probably going to be the main big bad at the end of the day. Absolutely. Dr. Connors, the Lizard, is in it. Spider-Man's first villain.
He keep mentioning Harry too, so I guess we're going to get Goblin maybe?
I hope so.
It seems like they're like, stay away from Harry is what like Peter kept saying.
Yeah.
So
I'm assuming that's at the very beginning of the game, this scene, because it was like a 10-minute gameplay trailer.
Yeah.
Which was surprising that they showed that much.
Well, that just means they're just that much more game, you know? Like, they did that with the original like Spider-Man when they showed like the... was it the Sinister Six? Is that what they're called?
Sinister Six, yeah.
Like they showed, and you would think like, oh, this is like a lot to show, but it's like not even close, dude. Like
for real, after the DLC in that game, what was it? It ended up being like 80 hours or something crazy.
Yeah.
And I played through every second. And same with the Miles Morales game. It wasn't as long because it was kind of just a remake of the first one. And then, well, they had the remake with the special edition or whatever, but the Miles one is basically like a DLC they made into their own game, the Miles Morales Spider-Man game. But I mean, that was like what, 30 hours for an expansion basically, which is nuts.
Didn't feel like it. I fucking played the shit out that one.
I know, I tore through it. I even went back and like got as many I didn't 100% it, but I got close. There's a couple, like some of those missions take forever, like the collection missions and stuff. All right, and then another big one. I don't know if you're a Metal
Gear. What a thrill.
I'm actually not a huge Metal Gear Solid fan.
Let me ask you, is it because you haven't played it, or is it just don't appeal to you?
No, I've played it. I actually own the Metal Gear Solid 2 on PS2, and I have the... I tried the... I forget what it's called. Sons of Liberty or whatever on PS4. I think it's 2.
Okay, gotcha. So, Guns of the Patriots.
Yeah, that one. Yeah.
Yeah, that's a weird one to start off on.
Well, no, I played the second one. Like I said, I played the second one on PS2, and I didn't beat it, but like it was fine. Like I had fun.
Well, I'll tell you a little stuff I think about this one. So Snake Eater is the third one in the series, but story wise, it's the first one, so it's like prequel.
So, I always forget, is Twin Snakes the one that was on GameCube?
That is the GameCube remake of the first game.
Okay. I liked that one. I did play that one. That one's my favorite out of the series.
That one was the coolest one. Out of all the, like, the remakes, I wish they would have done that one, but it makes sense they're starting with like this one.
Since it's the start of the like franchise, essentially.
And this is a fan favorite for sure. People love this one.
Yeah.
Okay. But Konami finally like shitting out a big game finally. So, but this will be the first time without Kojima. So that's going to be, I know it's a remake, but still it's, I wonder what they're going to do. If they're really just going to like boost the graphics and keep everything the same, or if it's just going to be from the ground up.
Usually though, when they remake, it's not a remaster, right? It's a remake. So usually when it's titled remake, they actually do make pretty big changes. So yeah, be interesting. Karen says, Ketsorin says, my fave Spidey is Miles Morales.
He is a good one.
Karen says, I love him. I'm still a basic bitch, and my narrow fave over him is Peter Parker. So
Miguel was a good one.
No, yeah, Miguel's great. Awesome. They're using him as the main villain in the Across the Spider-Verse.
Oh, really? I didn't know that. That's awesome.
Yeah, Miguel O'Hara, man.
You know what? When I first watched, what was the one before that? The movie.
Into the Spider-Verse.
There we go. Yeah. I missed the teaser at the end.
Oh, did him. You?
Yeah, because I left the theater because like I was like going ham on some snacks and I was embarrassed. I was like, I'm out of here. I'm not gonna let people see me in the light.
So, I'm kind of with Karen. Like, I'll always have a special place in my heart for Peter Parker because he was the OG, and that's like what got me started in superheroes and everything like that. But at the end of the day, like, he's my favorite. But my like what I tell who I tell people is my favorite is Gwen. I love Gwen so much. She's so awesome. And I've met all the creators except for Jason Latour, who is the writer. He did the stories, but he's the only one I haven't met, but I met the colorist and the artist, and they helped co-write the story anyway. So it's like, you know how it goes. Man, just such a good book. I love Gwen Stacy so much. She should have been with Peter.
Out of all the goofy ones though, I hope they bring spiders, man. That one was like my favorite, like what the fuck kind of Spider-Man character.
Dude, I mean, they have like everything that I saw. They even have like the bombastic Spider-Man with the with the bag on his head.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, and the Fantastic Four suit. They even have him in it. So I agree with you, Ketsorin. Miles Morales is the fucking shit. I love him so much.
Quick, going back to the like Spider-Man 2 game, when you can flip between the two, like immediately Miles is like, I want to play as Miles immediately. Like, he can fly around. He's got the electricity, invisible.
Yeah.
Like, Peter's cool and everything, but come on, man. Like, Miles is sick.
Well, yeah, Miles has the best, like, powers. That's not even up for debate. Like, the fact that he has Venom Strike and shit, too cool.
Yeah.
Too cool. So, yeah, we got off topic there a little bit, but...
Metal Gear,
yeah. So it looked good though. The little teaser they gave—I was already flipped through the pictures. It looks like they're going with all the big announcements first. That's fine. So here's like the biggest announcement they made. Probably is the dedicated game streaming device.
Their Switch version.
So no, it's actually Wii U version.
Later this year,
if we being all the way real.
So. I guess I thought you hooked your phone up or something like that to that. So that's the console right there.
It's not a console. It's just a screen with a controller on it.
Oh.
And you have to be on the Wi-Fi that your PlayStation is on to stream the games.
You know, they pretty much already did that with the PlayStation TV on the PS4. So I guess they're just like doubling down.
And they have earbuds. Thank God. What would we ever do without PlayStation earbuds?
Look, I got a big ass head, so thank you.
Yeah. So I got to say, I'm actually really disappointed in this announcement. I never owned one, but my roommate in college had a PS Vita, and he's one of my best friends, so I just borrowed it all the time. I loved the PS Vita so much.
Yeah.
The Steam Deck already exists where you can play your games anywhere. The Switch already exists where you can play your games anywhere. I just don't get it. Like, why make it like the Nintendo already did this with the Wii U. And like you said, the PlayStation TV, they already did it with that too, where you could stream it, you know, to your smart TV. I just don't get it. Yeah. Why?
You're right. I totally like forgot that they made like handhelds. That's how long it's been. Like, even watching this now, I was like, oh, well, this, I wouldn't see myself ever doing this. Like, why am I ever like in a situation where like I can't be next to my big ass TV?
Right.
And want to play like on this small thing.
I guess,
especially if you gotta hang around your Wi-Fi, like that's stupid.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. Like, I guess if you want to be in bed, or like if wifey wants to watch something or the kids, I guess that sort of makes sense, but I'd just spend $200 extra and get a Steam Deck and be able to play my games anywhere, everywhere, all the time, which I really want to do, by the way. I love Steam Decks. I think they're badass.
I haven't gotten one.
I haven't either, but my friend has one and I play it and I want one real bad. So yeah, that's my thoughts on that. I think it's a waste of time and it's going to flop.
For sure. That's probably why they're putting minimal like effort into it, maybe. I don't know. Maybe they realize like handhelds just don't do it no more in this aspect, but
yeah.
I guess they do because like the Steam Deck is because of the library and like everything you can play.
And you can mod it and do what you want with it, which is awesome. All right, and then there was Assassin's Creed Mirage. That was showing more of that October release date, which is kind of surprising that it's so soon, to be honest. I almost look for that to get delayed.
Have you been keeping up with the Assassin's Creed lore, or do you not care?
I do not care. I played the first one, the second one, the third one, and then I stopped.
Fair. Yeah, the story is, I think they're finally getting back to, like, telling a straight narrative.
I mean, that's
before it was ridiculous. Well, this one apparently is supposed to be going back to, like, how stealth is, and they're not going to focus on, like, the open world and tier systems, apparently. But we'll see.
Well, if that's the case, then I'll probably play it, because I think 2 was the best Assassin's Creed game, and it's not even close. Down. And again, it really leaned heavily into the sneaky and the parkour and yeah, I mean, this looks like Assassin's Creed 2.
Mm-hmm.
So if it's more like that, then give me that. Like, give me an Arkham parkour game. That's what I want.
There's a lot more Assassin's Creeds coming out too. Like, I know one is like during the Salem Witch Trials, and then there's 2 other ones coming out.
That could be cool. Salem Witch. Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, I don't have any more to say about that. What about you?
Yeah, nope, that's it.
All right. This one, very excited.
This is my biggest one, for sure.
I mean, Spider-Man's my biggest, but this is probably my second.
I cannot fucking wait. Remedy's like probably my favorite game studio. I came to realize that after like playing. I was like, man, I fucking love these games. Like, and yeah, this is great. Into darkness. Sam Lake, the guy who like directs it, is gonna star in it again. So that's pretty cool.
I love it.
He has the voice actor of Max Payne voicing him again, like he did in the first game, first Max Payne game. So that's pretty neat. Like, that's kind of like a callback to that as well. And then you play as 2 main characters. Like, you don't get just Alan Wake. You get like the FBI agent lady.
That's what I was going to bring up too. Like, I was shocked whenever you see the FBI agent and then you're over the shoulder, you know, playing as her. I was like, that's awesome.
Yeah.
Give me that.
It looks amazing. There's Sam Lake right there. But yeah.
The first Alan Wake's one of the best games ever made.
It's fucking phenomenal.
When this shot came up, I was like, dude, yes, let's fucking go.
It really feels like Resident Evil, like on her side of things,
Which I love.
And then like they show a bit of like Alan, like dealing with his like dark world presence shit.
Yep.
And that's pretty cool because it seems like it's like mutated into like a Night City type thing.
Yep.
So something's not right. I'm digging it. I can't wait. Easy. And then we got a date finally, so that's really good too.
Yep. First things first. What's your name? At one point, it felt like this game was never coming out.
No. And like, when I streamed, I went through all like the Remedy games, and I didn't realize in Quantum Break, when you start the game, there's immediately a teaser for Alan Wake 2, like original concept. And I just thought, I never thought anything of it. I thought it was like, oh, look at him being silly. But this is literally what he just showed. It's just with different actors.
So let's take a quick break here from this, and I want to ask you a question because I just thought of it, and this is what we do on the show. You know, you already know we divulge into random things. What is the game that was like never made that was like, you know, teased or like was supposed to come out that never came out that you're most disappointed didn't come out?
Prey 2.
Interesting. Okay.
That would have been like space Skyrim for me. Like, you're a bounty hunter in space and you can like just the way they like talked about it, and like what they showed a little bit of it, Like, you walked up to an alien guy and you're like, hey, you're coming with me, you're a bounty. He's like, no. And you could just shoot everybody around him and he reacted to that. And he's like, okay, I'm coming. Like, I thought that was, like, really cool. And then, like, the way you handcuff them, you throw a collar on their neck and send them to the brig. But Prey 2 was the one that was like, come on, man. But yeah. Then, like, they rebooted the whole series and went a whole different direction.
I know. Dang. The first one was such a cool concept, too. It was just the execution wasn't quite there. And it felt like 2 was like they were trying to hammer home those ideas that they had in the first game.
Another one I got, this is the one I like, I still hold on to all the time, is the original Final Fantasy 15 concept, which is like Final Fantasy 13 Versus. They gutted that game into what it is, into the nothing that it is now.
Yeah.
And I still hurt, it hurts me.
I'm not a Final Fantasy guy. That's one game series I just absolutely cannot get into, no matter how hard I try.
Really?
Yep. That's the one. That's the game series I can't get into.
Well, appreciate y'all having me on the podcast.
Come on. I know you have one that's like that. What game series can you absolutely not get into that you've tried?
I don't know. A series? I don't know.
Or maybe just game. Maybe just a game.
Oh, that, League.
Like, okay. Yeah. That's another one that not for me. But anyway, to answer my first question, to me, it's Silent Hills.
Oh my God. Yeah. I forgot about that. There's so many like shit like that.
Dude, but that teaser, PT is one of the best games ever made. And it's not even a game. It's a fucking playable trailer.
Yeah. I would have loved to see that direction where they were going into.
It was amazing.
But on the bright side though, it really felt like he was constrained to make something under Kojima. That is under a title he didn't really care about. And then they're like, Sony's like, hey, do what you want. He's like, Death Stranding. Hey, Norman Reedus, you're coming with me. We're going to make an even batshittier game. But the gameplay was so dog shit. Yeah. That's why I'm looking forward to like the second game to be like, oh, this is like a little bit better. Now that he's like stopped lashing out.
Yeah. Well, speaking of Final Fantasy.
Let's go. 16 looks dope. At first, I was not like about it because of like 15 left such a sour like taste in my mouth.
This one looks closer to the way they used to be, right?
Mm-hmm. Well, this one is made by the guys who made 14, specifically Yoshi P, the guy who like saved 14 from Oblivion. I don't know if you know any of the lore of like Final Fantasy 14 and how that development went down, but 14's their MMO, and they were like getting dunked on. So like he, Yoshi P, that is, like,
yeah,
completely wiped the servers and just started fresh. And then it's written lore. Anyway, Yoshi P's writing this one. Nice. So, and the guys who made one of like the Heavensward DLCs, which is an expansion to that. And this is the first one I think that has like an M rating or like a higher rating than that, because they're like, we want to make a gritty story. So
they having sex and stuff.
Probably. I read that it was about the blood. The blood was like a big issue because, like, I guess I didn't realize it's in 7. There's no blood, even in the remake. It's always like purple goo or like a shadowy shit. So he's like, "Hey, I don't want to do that. I'm telling like a Knight's Tale. Like, can I just have blood?" And they're like, "Yeah, I guess."
Can I tell you the only Final Fantasy game I've actually ever played like a decent amount of?
What's that?
Final Fantasy 12.
Yeah.
On the PS2.
That's one I tried to get into, and like by the time I got there, it was a little dated for me. I was like, eh.
Yeah, no, I get it. I played it, like, I don't know, 10 years ago at this point, so it wasn't as bad.
Are you into the turn-based, like, gameplay like that?
Dude.
Any type of game?
Dude, Knights of the Old Republic's my favorite game of all time.
I don't know if that counts. Like, I don't know. I feel like that's more, like, action-y kind
of. It's action turn-based, so it's different. But, yeah, no, I like turn-based. Like, Bravely Default, I loved the first one. Gotcha. The second one I thought was terrible. They made a lot of dumb changes to that. But, let's see. Oh, shit. What?
Do you play Octopath?
So, it's been on my radar and, like, in my to play list forever, and I just haven't done it yet.
That game's pretty cool.
Turn-based real-time strategy. I mean, I love the Fire Emblem games. They're like my favorite game series. Well, one of my favorite game series is, so.
Hell yeah. You ever play Persona?
Nope.
Or any of the Shin Megami Tensei games?
No, haven't had a chance. Seems like a lot of those games, like when I retire, I'm just every game I'm going to just play every day. I'm just going to play through every game I missed out on that. Like, I, you know, just give me 30 more years and I'll just be that old man. I'll just be playing games literally all day, every day.
That'll like, be my retirement. As I get older, those like Persona games make me sadder because it's like, play as a high school student with all these girlfriends. It's like, I don't want to do this. Like, this is
Dragon Dogma 2.
So I understand why people are hyped for this one. I played the first one, but for me, this is like, not that it's mid or anything. I am interested, but it's not like, yes, like some people, but.
Yeah, I'm not huge on it either. I think we can move on unless chat wants to talk about it.
Did you play the first one?
Nope. Dude, I'm such a picky gamer. Like,
nah, I get it.
I'm a gamer, but like, I stick to games. Like,
yeah.
I'm a big competitive gamer too, so that's why I play like Overwatch, Rocket League, Halo, Smash Bros.
You know, I'm also like whatever about this game because it spanked the shit out of me on the first one. So I'm like, yeah, I'm not doing that again.
Yeah. So this, speaking of Halo, and earlier Bungie, so this is crazy. So Marathon was a game that they had on the original Mac.
This is the first game, right?
Or not PCs, the Macs. Yeah, it was like their first game they ever made was Marathon. This is a complete different game. It's not a remake. It's just they use the old Same Marathon game. Moniker. But yeah, it's a new entry into the series. It's a FPS, like a team-based FPS, PvP-focused. I'm very excited for this. Instead of, you know, Destiny, where it's like, there's PvP, but it's, you know, PvE is really what they focus on with that. This seems more like their Halo replacement.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm very excited for that.
It's a, like a looter, like extraction shooter, right? Or something like that. Like, so, isn't that going to be like more like Tarkov kind of stuff like that?
Is it?
You go in there trying to take stuff? Maybe. I mean, that's so. What I read. I mean, so like you go in there, try to take shit, leave. But like, as you see this, that dude got shot. So he's like, I walk away with nothing. And then they're taking his heart or something or whatever that is.
Yeah, I don't know. But yeah, I am very excited for this. I think this could be amazing. And I love the flair too. The music is amazing. Mm-hmm. Like the cyberpunky vibe. Like, give me that shit. Very excited for that.
Absolutely.
Another look at Street Fighter 6. Are you going to get Street Fighter 6?
You know, I've missed the whole Street Fighter hype. Like, mm-hmm. I mean, I'll play with like on the arcade machines at a friend's house, but like, I'll never actually get it myself just because I don't know, like sick. I mean, I Mortal Kombat and Tekken are my things.
I got it. I mean, Smash is my fighter. So like, I'm a casual Street Fighter fan. I've played all of them. I played more than others. Like I played 4 a lot. I played 2 a lot back in the day. I played them all. 5 was terrible and it left a really sour taste in players' mouths. But 6 looks good. I'm not going to lie to you. And the fact that it's got such a heavily focused story mode too, I'm about it.
Is this the first time they're doing like the story stuff?
So they've had like some before, but not to this extent, I don't think.
Gotcha.
I'm pretty hyped for this, and I might actually be a day one player. It comes out next week, June 2nd, I believe. Paths
with many. I will say one thing that looked hilarious and like awesome about this game is that you can play as a guy and just like walk up to a lady with groceries, like put him down, lady, or box him.
Yep. I think that's hilarious too.
My journey knows no end.
Good old Ryu.
I will continue to do what I have always done. When you said you were seeking strength. Having no
me,
to do so.
These guys.
Honestly, I thought you were a complete idiot.
I forget her name.
Masters, he was set up.
When I say I'm a casual fan, like I know some of the characters.
Yeah.
I'm not nearly strong enough to chase after a monster.
I mean, I know how to throw a Hadouken. About it.
Yep, same. obviously, since we fought each other in Street Fighter 2.
As E Honda is like still around, that was like my guy because he's got like the wall of slaps.
You know, I don't know. But I was weird because they had a bunch of paywall characters, like DLCs.
I will say, like, this gaming like cycle or season or what you want to call it, like Capcom's been killing it. Like,
yeah, no doubt.
Resident Evil 4 like came out, like I think I mentioned this last podcast, but like,
yeah,
it wasn't broken, it worked fine. I totally forgot about that shit.
Yeah.
All the Monster Hunters are fantastic. So.
Yeah, so that's another game series I can't really get into is Monster Hunter. I get the appeal, but I don't know. It's just...
Which one have you played?
I tried the one that was free for PS4. I don't remember which one that one was, but...
World. Yeah. See, I can't get into that one. That one, even though it's like the pretty one, yeah. There's one that came out on the Switch called Rise, and that one is way... I put so many hours in that one because that one's just straight hunting monsters. Like, the world is very much just like, oh, look how pretty everything is, and actually look for this thing. It's like, this is boring.
Hey, remember when games used to be simple and you got enjoyment out of playing games because of the gameplay? Yeah,
I remember.
Dude, I feel like I'm getting so old because all these, like, trendy features, not even trendy, just like, what's the word I'm looking for there? There's a word I'm looking for. I can't. I'm so tired.
Trendy features.
No, it's like it's like gimmicks. I couldn't think of the fucking word gimmick. All these gimmicks with gameplay. That's like, oh, see, we're different. I'm like, no, you're not. You're just being annoying.
Yeah.
You know, games have worked in a particular way for a long time for a reason. I don't know. I just think there's too many gimmicks in games, and like some of the simple gameplay stuff is like, that's why I love like Fire Emblem so much, is because it's just simple. It's like, okay, it's like rock, paper, scissors, but with pretty character models, and you know, they throw in gimmicks, but it's like, doesn't completely hinder you if you don't understand it, you know?
Absolutely.
What is this? Jade Raymond's Haven Studio reveals Fair game. I don't even remember seeing this.
This is like not Watch Dogs, I think.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. I don't know. I'm not interested.
No, not even a little bit.
No.
Especially like when they're just showing like a full cinematic. Like, we're just going to get another Redfall. Like, I don't really care.
The Talos Principle 2. I'm not super... I don't care about this either, to be honest.
I don't even know what it is. Like, I don't even know what we're doing here. That was a cool, like, trailer, but, like...
Yeah.
We're a robot who, like, I don't know, builds stuff? I don't...
I guess...
I'm sure there's somebody out there who's like, yes!
It's like Roblox, right? I don't know.
I have no clue. Like, it just... I think it's one of those, like, artsy games where it's just like, robots have feelings, too. It's like, they don't.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm out. Foam Stars is their Splatoon.
Blatantly so.
Yeah. And it doesn't look good. Even with the surfing, which is kind of a cool feature, does not look good. Not interested in that one bit.
Nope.
The Plucky Squire. I actually didn't think this looked very good either. And I'm typically a fan of indie games.
Can't remember what that one was.
It's just like the little adventure game that's like platformer.
Oh, gotcha. Yeah, okay. Yeah, I mean, it's
actually, it's not a platformer. Not a, well, yeah, it is. The Plucky Squire and his friend. It looks like Legend of Zelda mixed with Mario and with
cute. Yeah, characters. There's a lot of colors.
Yeah. I actually was not impressed by this at all.
What?
I didn't think this looked good.
I'll tell you what. It looks good, but I can guarantee you none of that will happen when you play that game. Like,
but that's what I'm saying. It was all cinematic bullshit, and I almost guarantee it's going to come out and be underwhelming.
100%. Like, remember Oolong? Did anybody really give a fuck about that game after? Nope. Like,
no.
Like,
it's, they promise all this stuff in these little trailers and these little, you know, specific run-throughs, and none of it ever works that way.
Yeah, it's like too much. Like, you know, he's like doing like certain flips and stabbing. It's just like there's no way I could possibly command a dude to do that, like, unless he does that himself.
Right. Simple is better. Let's be real. That's why a steak with light seasoning is still the best food you can eat. It's tried and true, you know, medium. Give me that. Good cut. That's what I want.
Medium.
I mean, it looks pretty. But doesn't
it? I want it to be true. Like, I want it to be like, this is.
Sure.
This is going to be sick. But we all know, like, we've been hurt before.
Yeah.
And this is not going to be the case.
And, like, it really feels like one of those games is going to come out and just not be playable. Like, it's going to be buggy. I guarantee it's going to be buggy. This game is. Write it down now. This game will have problems at launch. Promise.
Like, he's just moving way too fast. And, like, again, like you said, it's a cinematic.
Yeah.
There's also this funny part where, like, he's, like, running up a beam that doesn't need to be run up on. It's like, so everything can... That can happen all the time? Like, I don't...
Right.
Like, there it is. Like, what'd you do that for?
Yeah. And again, that looked like a cutscene style, so...
Yeah.
Do you press a button and activate that? Okay.
Like I said, I hope I'm, like, pleasantly surprised because...
Sure. No, it looks neat.
When Last of Us 2 was first shown, like, with the trailer where they're fighting a dude in, like, the convenience store, and, like, she's, like, slipping through, in between, like, shelves and stuff like that. I was like, that's not gonna happen. And, like, when he hit it, like, the books fell off. Like, but to my surprise, that all does happen. So,
yeah.
I don't know.
But also, look at the studio difference. I'm just saying.
100%.
What was your thoughts on The Last of Us 2?
Story-wise, it was all right. Gameplay-wise, it's phenomenal. I thought it was great.
Yeah. I actually, like, people shit on that game because of the story. And, like, I don't know what people wanted them to do. Like, the first one was groundbreaking story-wise, so they had to take a risk. I was actually happy they tried something different.
Well, I wish they would have tried something a little bit more different. Like, I love the cliffhanger that is the first game.
Yeah.
And I wish they would have just left it at that. And then just told another story in the universe.
Like, but just Abby's story, maybe?
Yeah. Or, like, again, spoilers for people for a fucking old ass game.
It's been out for how long? 4 years?
But I wish we would have started with Abby, played her story up until the Joel part. And then I could, because, like, now I'm conflicted. Because, like, we played as her after she did all the heinous shit, and it's like, fuck this lady. I don't want to play as her. Like, she killed one of my favorite characters. Like, so that was my biggest thing. And it's like, why should I care about Abby? But at the end, you realize why you should. And it's like, yeah, I guess. Fair enough.
Yep. See, I like that. I like the fact that they made you play this character that you obviously hate for what she did. And at the end, you have sympathy for her.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I like it.
Like I said, the gameplay is like...
Oh, it's top tier. Top tier.
Like... It's great.
Yep. As far as horror games goes, probably the best controls.
Yeah, for sure.
Ghost Runner 2, don't care.
You know, it looks pretty. But, like, it looks like a speedrunner's wet dream. Like, I don't really get... You're just moving? Like,
yeah. I'm just not a speedrunner guy. One. Like, it's whatever.
You get a bike now, I guess. Like, he wasn't fast enough already. Like,
right. So, earlier in the show, because I see the next announcement that we're going to talk about here. Earlier in the show, we talked about...
Stormtroopers? Or not Stormtroopers.
Starship Troopers, the game. And how we wanted to do a collab playing it. And this is definitely Starship Troopers, the answer.
Have you played the first Helldivers?
I have not.
So... Have you seen it at all? Because this is like a massive upgrade from the first game. Because the first game is very much top down. And it's just, I mean, it's still it's very fun. Like, don't get me wrong, but this looks way more immersive. And I can't wait for it.
It looks really pretty. And I'm all for PvE. So
mm-hmm.
I'm cool with that. Koron, what's up, buddy? Thanks for joining, brother. He says, The Last of Us 2 was a masterpiece. Agreed. Thank you. We did talk about the Metal Gear Solid 3 remaster.
Yes. What a thrill.
We did talk about that. I'm not huge on it, but Sal is very excited. I'm not huge on Metal Gear Solid. It's just not for me. More flirting in the chat. Jesus. Okay, now this is a game. This is what I'm hyped for. This is my number two most excited thing about behind.
Oh, this is the Spider-Man. The Journey people.
Yes. Oh my God, Journey. If you have never played it, it takes like 4 hours tops. It's one of the most beautiful games ever made. Like simple story, but just gorgeous and just a really fun playthrough. And this is their next. This is their next story that they're telling and next game in their series.
You know what's funny? I was watching this with Reap and she saw the sand. She's like, Journey 2. It was just so funny. She just knew right away by the animation style.
Oh, I was like, as soon as I saw it, I was like, this is Journey. What's up with that? But come on, look at this.
Yeah, it's really, these games are so like beautiful and like
they make you feel some type of way. And like if a game could make me feel that way, that's beautiful. That is art, man. Like we need more of that. And I love
it. Chill and quiet, but so impactful.
Yeah, and I love the fact that we're like surfing on sand. That's so cool.
Yeah, he's got like a treasure planet type thing going, like surfboard.
Koron says the lack of Silent Hill 2 info at the PlayStation panel was a bummer. Yeah,
they might show it. We still got some stuff going, right? Because like Xbox is going to show a thing.
Yeah, they're going
to. And I would imagine.
Which, by the way, I said all Xbox has to do to win this year is say that they have their own Steam Deck handheld that you can play anywhere, that they can pull exactly the way they can pull off exactly what Sony did to them during the PS4 Xbox One era, where they just completely 360'd on their plans about the game sharing and stuff like that. And you remember that? Like they had initially were going to do all the same stuff that Microsoft was doing with the always online and the game sharing. And they saw how bad they were received for that. And so they just completely changed their plans and announced it. And I swear if Microsoft just does that and they're like, oh, here's our handheld and you can play it anywhere. You don't need, cause you already can with a mobile phone. Like,
yeah,
you can play it anywhere. You can stream your games anywhere. With the Xbox Games Pass.
I'll tell you what I'm looking forward to as far as Xbox, like what they should do in my opinion is like restart that fucking Kinect like technology, dude. Cause like,
yeah,
the Kinect was like
really good
before its time. Dude. Like you didn't need anything. You just needed that fucking thing and just stood in front of it and you can play a game. No one else has that going on.
You didn't need the stupid controllers, the dumb, like I can't see what I'm doing. Headset, like you just play in front of the TV. Dude, 100% the Kinect was, and I'll tell you a good example of that was, it was a dumb game. Like it wasn't like it was a fun game just because of the gameplay, but like the concept of it was pretty dumb. It was like that Rapids game that came with the Kinect. Oh my God, man, that was such a good use of that technology.
The Fable game was cool because like you would like summon spells like slapping your hands together and doing some cool shit. But the biggest one was like Skyrim. Like I remember you drew, like you pretended like you drew a bow.
Yeah.
And it would do it. Yeah. Like, you know, you would do shouts by like standing a certain thing. Anyway, my point being is like, they just said, fuck all that. And it's like, no, dude, you were onto something big. Like,
yep. I'm sure it was not cheap to produce. So
no, not at all.
And like I remember they took a hit whenever they had the Xbox Kinect and they launched it. They took a hit on they actually lost money on console sales for that because the Kinect was so expensive. But they were hoping to make up for it with game sales and it just didn't come to fruition because it was an expensive console bundle at the time.
Yeah, ahead of their time for sure.
Yeah.
But like, you know what? People are willing to buy shit now. Like if it works and plays good, so.
I know. Seriously, man, like that's a great point because I like VRs are cool, but I just don't want to sit with a fucking goggles on and like thing on my head. You know what I mean?
It's taxing. It's very exhausting.
Yeah. Caron says Journey was fantastic. One time playthrough. It was whack after that. Once the game was shortened and you didn't have to play through the entire time. Yeah, I mean, but that's what it's amazing about is like you get that one playthrough experience. And like, I wish there were more games like that where I could just get a full experience for out of 4 hours.
Yeah, because like you play it once and like it's stuck with you forever, right? I mean,
right. Resident Evil 4 remake on VR. Okay.
Yeah, we were just bitching about this. There's no way like this feels like too much. Like it that does. Game is like, I saw like it looks cool in concept, but like, I mean, I can only play VR for like maybe 2 hours. Like when I first got it, I was able to play like a long amount of times, but like now I don't know what it is, but I can't even bother. I can't fucking imagine, especially the scene where you're in the courtyard or whatever. Yes. And like you got to block with like the sword and like, what if you got to dodge? Do I actually got to like bend down and shit? Like every fight, it's like, I'm going to be exhausted. Like I got to do actual flips and break everything in my room. Like
mentally taxing too. Just like thinking about all that, you know?
Yeah.
Like it's harder to react with your hands quickly than it is to press buttons quickly. So yeah.
I mean, people good for people who like VR like that, but nah.
Yeah, Five Nights at Freddy's. I know a couple of friends that are excited for this, but I just I'm not a fan.
You know, I don't want to play these games at all, but I'm for some reason I'm glad the lore is like as big as it is to the point where like they are making a movie now, and like, you know, I like watching people play it. I personally just don't give a fuck.
Reaper says, "What? You don't actually want to fight for your life?" Yeah, I'm good. All right, moving on.
I do that every day.
Grizz Creator.
This is like,
this looks cool. This actually does look cool.
It looked cool, but like the way they showed this at the PlayStation like thing is like, it's beautiful. Everything's great. The fucking cute animal dies, and then immediately after that it was like Cat Quest. Yeah, it's like, man, just the emotional 180.
Yeah.
Like what the fuck? I don't even know what you do in this game though. Like,
I don't either. But it looks cool.
It does.
Caron says, I'm hyped for the Fanth, the movie. I mean, that actually could be cool.
They're going, I didn't know there was such a deep lore until they announced the movie, and people were like, no, let me fill you in. It's like, what in the fuck?
Dude, that is like, Fanth people are a cult, man. They like... They're all about that shit. Yeah, like you can tell this game has good writing.
Yeah.
Just from little snippet.
I feel like it's going to be like a Journey thing where like the storytelling's told in the action, not really the words.
Right.
So we'll see. It looks like an Ori type thing where it's like, hey, you were chilling, but now you got to like move on. It's not safe here anymore.
Yeah. First Ori is great. Second one, I wasn't a huge fan of. Dude, it makes me sad.
Yeah, the dog said bow ow. Now you gotta like take care of like a dog, a pup. It's like, I don't know. How do you feed a dog? I don't have any kibble.
So yeah, 2024. And then Cat Quest. This actually does look kind of fun.
That was immediately after that trailer, and I was like, no, I'm not ready.
Like Cat Pirates is so cute. That's fun.
The Peruvian begins. Peruvian
Pirates of the Peruvian. Yeah. Peruvian.
Peruvian. Yeah.
Peruvian.
Yeah, it's kind of like kind of hurts your head a little bit.
Reminds me of Maple Story.
I think this is a mobile game. Or is it? Like the first one was, and then now this is coming out.
Oh. Okay.
That's what, like, nerds in my chat were like, oh, this is fucking... This is the one.
2024. I love it.
How did they like that to clarify? They're like, 2024. No, seriously.
Coron says a Maple Story reference in 2023. Dude, people still play that game, surprisingly. Towers of I don't know how to say this, is a Breath of the Wild like game. I don't know. I'm out on this, I think.
It looks like Breath of the Wild with none of the charm.
Yep.
Like it looks very much just like clunky as fuck.
Yep.
Like when he's trying to like jump on like the thing's backs, it's like, oh man, you could tell it doesn't want you to do that at all.
Yeah.
It wants you to fall and die to your death. And... but yeah, I don't know. Yeah, I'm good on this.
Yep. Moving on. Revenant Hill.
These are the guys who made Night in the Woods. And I guess they're trying like a different kind of game going on.
Okay.
I don't know if you ever played Night in the Woods, very story heavy. People love it. I've never actually played it myself, but same dudes.
Okay. This was a very short teaser.
Yeah. Yeah, they don't really have to say much because all their like fucking fans are like,
oh! Same. Yeah. Grand Blue Fantasy Relink. This looks like, if I remember correctly, this looks like it's a turn-based RPG, right?
I think this one's an action one.
Is this one?
But,
oh, yeah, that's right.
But I think the other ones were turn-based at one point. This is a long-running series, so.
Yeah.
You're like, what's up, weebs? Back with another.
Yep. Whatever, I'm good on that, too. Ultros. Yeah, I'm out on the Metroidvania games. Like, I've played them to death.
I want to like this one, but this, it just, there's a lot on the screen going on. Like, with the colors, it looks like,
the background is very distracting.
Someone said that, I heard someone say, like, the only time you see these art styles is, like, on beer cans and, like, weed shops. So, like, it's very much just like, okay. I don't know if I want to look at this for several hours.
Yeah, you get the idea. Everyone's played those kind of games. Here's this.
Nope, another gotcha game. We're definitely on this one. I'm gonna speak for you. This one ain't it.
You know what sucks though is it looks neat.
Like, yeah.
With the different forms of transportation and stuff. But yeah, I'm out.
Yeah, you want that horse? Good luck.
Yeah. Give me $40.
You'll be fucking thousands of dollars in debt.
And then VR, don't give a shit.
Out of all the VR shit that, like, showed here, Arizona Sunshine was, like, the most, like, weirdest trailer because, like, they showed, like, such a shitty, like, 360-style trailer.
Yeah.
But, like, the game is good, like, the first game, so, like,
is
more
it?
Of the same. Okay. Oh, yeah. It's a blast. It's actually really fun.
Okay.
If you ever go to, like, VR, like, places, usually 9 times out of 10, Arizona Sunshine will be on there.
Okay.
So, yeah.
Concord, like this looked neat, but who knows what it is? It's just like a little trailer. There's no gameplay.
Yeah, it's a ship flying through. I wonder if there's like additional, like, should I know what this is? Like, you know, like,
no idea.
Because they're really showing nothing and like expecting you to be hyped for it.
Yeah. I mean, it's a neat trailer, I guess, with a jiggly burger.
Yeah, who leaves a burger like that unfinished? Like,
I don't know. Fuck off, to be honest. Like, I love the flair, the 80s, like, Tron style. Like, that's neat. But I know nothing about it.
Yeah, 100%.
Immortals of Avium? I don't know anything about this.
This is, like, the first person, like, spell casting kind of game.
Oh, you know what? Sir? I actually think this looks fun. It's the
hand. It might be. Follow. It very much looks like the same aesthetic as Forspoken, so that's why I'm like,
Gotcha. Maybe engage a little. I forgot that game existed.
Yeah, as you should have. We were all trying to.
Right. Actually, I remember like years ago whenever they announced that at E3 for the first time, everyone was so hyped for it, and then it just kept getting delayed, and they finally were just like, fuck it, we're going to release it, and then it was bad.
Mm-hmm. Well, I don't know. Like, I remember that was their, like, tech demo. That was their selling point for PS5. It's like, look at these rocks.
Right.
And this upcoming game. Like, this shit looks awesome, don't it?
Yep.
What's funny enough, though, the actress who plays, like, the main Forspoken lady is anything good. She was also on the Resident Evil show.
Oh, that's rough. So, the thing that looks fun about this to me is it very much seems like Doom. but with but with magic.
Metal Gear Solid. Okay. I'm trying to think of the third one. Let me look this up again. Oh, Spider-Man 2, obviously. Sorry. Yeah.
Okay. Spider-Man 2 for me is A1. Alan Wake 2 is second. And third is... It's kind of tough, but I'm going to go, even though I don't know much about it, Marathon, just the prospect of it, I'm excited for it. So, yeah.
Is there something you wish they would have shown?
Like, maybe a better... Like, there wasn't many exclusives. And, you know, maybe, like, a big exclusive that, like, new IP. That would have been cool.
See, one game I'm hoping on, like, and I hope they just, like, revitalize is, like, the Jak and Daxter series. Like, I wish they'd just make one more.
They won't. Like, they won't.
Yeah.
That would be cool. That was a good series. Chat, what about you? What was your top three? Everybody say it before we leave here. So, Sal, thank you so much for coming on the show. Tell everyone where they can find you and what you do. Talk about that for a hot second.
Sure. So as you can see, I am a Salamander VTuber. So you can come over to my channel, twitch.tv/salary, and just watch me play stupid games. I'm probably going to start Spider-Man, funny enough, because the game announcement for 2 got me hyped. So I re-downloaded it, got the PS5 port. So we're going to start and play that through that in Miles Morales.
Hell yeah.
So come check that out.
Sal does good work. He's got a very fun stream. And you never know. I gifted a sub last one of his last streams. So if you come on there, you might get gifted a sub from me. You never know. thanks for being our number one fan, Sal.
Yeah.
We really appreciate you always coming and hanging out with us. And thanks for hanging out with me and co-hosting with me tonight as a Salamander.
Thanks for the invite.
Hell yeah. Thanks, brother. All right. So do you know how to take us out? I want you to take us out. Do you know what you want to say?
Stay nerdy, gamers, right? Is that how to say
it? Well, until next time, stay nerdy. That's all you got to say.
Okay. Until next time, stay nerdy.
All right. Bye, guys. Bye.
Bye.